Now let's talk about user management, security, permission, access control, you name it. Orchards, of course, since it's a pretty full-blown CMS, not only has content management capabilities, but also user management capabilities. And all of these you can access under the security settings. But do note that not everything is enabled by default still. So if you go to the feature screen again, you will see that there are several features encompassing the user management functionality that are actually not enabled. For example, well, you can configure recap/checkup channels on the register and login and forgot password screens to prevent bots from abusing the system. But more applicable on every site is that there are also various features to let the users change their emails, let users register in the first place, because that's not necessary on every website. Sometimes you just need a couple of admin users to access it, or it's probably even just a single admin user. You don't actually need to allow anybody to register. Password reset is a separate feature too, as well as the ability to configure the time zone for each user. Because, well, we have seen that there is a default time zone under site settings, but there can also be separate time zones for every authenticated user. Because when date time or something like that is displayed on the front end or on the admin of Orchard, then it's always stored in UTC, in the Universal Coordinated Time in the database, but converted to the current display time zone, which is by default the default time zone on the fly. And now that we have these users features enabled, we'll have a bit more menu items and features here under the security settings. Well, as you can see, for example, we can configure everything related to login. Now, there are a lot of settings here, and a lot of settings are not relevant to a lot of use cases, so we won't go over everything. Do note, though, that the authentication and user management features of Orchard built on top of what's built into ASP.NET Core. So that also means that if you want to hook into the authentication pipeline, you can use the similar extension point. And also, if you want to add other authentication options, like single sign-on with an external provider, starting with existing implementations for general ASP.NET Core applications is a good starting point. Orchard actually has a lot of authentication options built in. And while we won't look through them, do note that there are these. For example, there is GitHub authentication. There are a lot more authentication options built in. There is also OpenID support. And again, all of these are well documented on the documentation side. For now, just note that there are many authentication options, and this is also, again, the flexibility and extensibility of Orchard. If you want to hook into the authentication pipeline, you can do it. If you want to override how users register, you can also do it. Now, the login settings are, as I said, fairly extensive. Similarly, we have quite a few settings for registration. Do note that by default, even if you have the registration feature enabled, registration is not allowed. You have to specifically set this to allow registration to actually let users register. Do go through these settings if you want to open up your site to user registrations, because, well, there is a lot of stuff to configure. And similarly, there are a lot of other settings. That's not that interesting. What's more interesting is that we have a list of users here too. So remember that during setup, we have created a super user. That super user is actually here. And if we edit it, we'll see that it has the username and the email address we have configured during setup, as well as by default, it got the administrator role. So as I said, the super user created during setup is in the end just an ordinary user, but it's the first one. And as you can see, you can also enable and disable user accounts. So a disabled user account, of course, will prevent the user from logging in. That's actually the good approach if you want to revoke the access of somebody. So we can also delete user accounts. And this delete here actually will be a hard delete because users aren't content items. But instead of deleting a user account, it's usually a better practice to just disable it. Because then everything related to that user account will still be available. Every relation of that user account to content items or anything else will still continue to live. But the user won't be able to just log in. And since we enabled the edit password feature as well, you can also directly edit the password as users here. Usually that's not a good practice, but sometimes it's just easier for some troubleshooting. And of course, you can also add users here. So you can add new users here. You can let users register on the front end. These are all possible to configure here. And there's one thing, roles. What are roles? Well, related to user management, there are two basic things that we need to cover. There is authentication, and then there is authorization about checking whether the user is actually the person they say they are. But that doesn't necessarily let the user do anything in the system. That's why we have authorization, because authorization is about checking what the user is allowed to do. It's about access control, permissions. And well, there is of course access control in Orchard, and we can check out the details of that under roles. Orchard uses role-based access control, which is a commonly used approach. Basically, the idea is that you have roles, which are not user groups, because it's rather that a user has roles and they can have multiple roles than a group has users. So we have various roles here, and well, for example, we can check out the administrator role under edit here. And as you can see, a role is pretty much a set of permissions. We have a lot of permissions here related to a lot of features. For example, the contents feature, which is the module and feature that's responsible for most of the basic content management functionality, exposes a lot of such permissions. And this is also completely extensible and configurable. So you can create your own roles, you can delete roles, you can also create your own features from modules, which we'll also see. Again, batteries are included, but well, first of all, you can customize everything, and secondly, you can also extend everything and bring your own. And related to the contents feature, you see that, well, we have some basic content management permissions here, and correspondingly, we see whether the current role possesses that permission, whether the current permissions are granted to that role. And well, the allow column is about permissions that you want to specifically allow in this role, while effective is what's already given to the role. Because sometimes permissions can implicitly depend on, can implicitly grant each other. For example, if you possess the permission for editing content items for others, implicitly you will also possess the permission to edit it for yourself. And secondly, the administrator role has all the permissions, so pretty much everything is granted already. And that is because the administrator role has the site owner's permission granted. This basically overrides everything. If you have that, then you can do anything in the system. But if we take a look at some more restrictive role, for example, the authenticated role, we will see that, well, the authenticated users don't just have any permissions. They pretty much only have this view all content and maybe one other. The view all content permission is for accessing content items on the front end. So unless users have this view all content permission granted, they won't really be able to do much on the front end. Well, they will still be able to access other pages, which are not content pages, but programmatic pages. But still, this is probably the most important permission for ordinary users. And I would also emphasize some of these roles here. All of these roles are the default roles, but again, you can also add your own role and you can also delete these roles. But the authenticated and anonymous roles are necessary because these are implicitly, all affected users are implicitly in this role or have this role already. The anonymous role is, of course, for users who are not authenticated at all. So if somebody opens the site without anything, they will possess the anonymous role. So under this role, you can specify what just any user can do. And by default, view all contents is granted, but as we can see, pretty much nothing else. Well, except something related to the Lucene feature, which is about search indexing. And then there is also the authenticated role, which is also implicitly given to everybody who, well, authenticates. By default, there is not much in there because it's better not to give permissions out and err on that side versus granting too many permissions by mistake. But you can check out the built-in permissions, play around, and grant various permissions depending on your specific use case. And remember that previously we have seen something called the Securable Metadata. Let's check it out again. Let's go to blog post, and we see that it isn't securable. Well, let's take this and let's see what happens. I'm also saving this content type, and let's now go back to the security settings and let's check out roles. Let's see whether we have some new permissions there. Yeah, and let's check out the outer role for a change now. And if I search for blog post, or well, just blog, you see that now we have this category here called blog post. And they have some familiar permissions here because again, we have publish and edit for others and publish and edit blog post. So the usual content permissions are generated here, but just for blog post. Now, what is happening here is that out of the box, certain features in Orchard have their own permissions. Which permissions are directly authorized against. And then there are also dynamic content permissions, which will be generated if your content type is securable. These dynamic content permissions basically give you content item level permissions for a whole content type. So if you take edit and publish blog post for others and own, then that means that the users with this role, well, they will be able to blog on this site. Do note that there is also this access admin panel permission, which is a basic permission necessary for the users to actually get into the admin area. Unless they have that, they can't really do anything related to content item content management. So if you want users of a role to edit some content items, like manage the blog, you will need to, well, first of all, make that content type securable. Secondly, specify or grant the necessary permissions, and also not forget ticking access admin panel here too. And one more thing related to user management, which is not user management itself, is email messaging. So we have seen that you can enable registration for users, and well, I just did that, but if you opt to also let users or require users to verify the email addresses, then a confirmation email will be sent out. And this is a good example of loose dependencies between features. Because, well, if I enable this, then everything looks all right, but we'll actually also need the email feature for it. And this is already enabled, so nothing else necessary apart from configuring it. But do note that we have the user registration feature, which is a completely independent feature of email messaging, but the two still work together. And well, the user registration feature will send out the confirmation emails with the email feature, of course. So if you want to enable registrations, then do configure SMTP settings here, because, well, otherwise Orchard won't be able to just send emails.